Hey, is this you?
I'm not sure. Sorry, everybody, I'm sick.
Yeah, she's sick, all right. I'm blowing all your germs away.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. At least I get dressed up, no. Right?
Hi, Hussein. Number 7.
Welcome, everybody.
Hi, Deborah.
To the Kindergarten
Luck,
Show.
Luck is the love monster.
It is. Season 7, episode 5. Episode 5.
What? Coconut drink.
Do what?
A coconut drink. Oh. Did you miss it?
Mm-mm.
It's a coconut drink. Wow. Well, you know how she's been. You got cough drops, right?
Yes. I have 2 cough drops in my mouth. Currently have 2 cough drops in my mouth. Still not better. Ken gets sick, and he's better the next day. Barbie gets sick, takes a month.
Yeah, it does. It's true.
So we were in Vegas. We literally were in Vegas yesterday. And I was so sick, and I started vomiting. And we came home. We were supposed to go from Vegas to California, to LA.
I wore my Vegas shirt. I'm still in the Vegas mood. Hey, Deborah's seen the shirt. I got to wear it again.
Yes.
It's all like beads. It's kind of a heavy shirt. But I love it. I don't get to wear it very often.
He loves it.
I don't get to, this is Jack.
So we left Vegas.
Jack of Diamonds.
We skipped California. We came straight home. Wow. On the way home, Ken stopped and droned, and then he stopped and droned, and then he stopped
well,
and droned.
Well, okay, let me
and
tell
then he
this
stopped
story.
And
here,
droned.
You just suck on your cough drop. Okay? And so we went to Mead Lake, which is outside of Vegas, and it was great. I mean, it was nice and sunny and everything. I droned for, I don't know, I used 2 batteries, full batteries, so, and I was just droning and droning. I went 2 miles out. I went 12,000 feet with the drone.
And then we went to another lake.
It was pretty awesome. But
and then we went to a river.
Yeah, we went to the, well, first.
It took us 10 hours to do a 4-hour drive.
9
hours to do a 4-hour drive. And I'm sick the whole time.
But what's weird about that is we didn't drone all those extra hours. We're not droning.
I was picking the droning spot. Is this the right spot?
Well, the next time we pass through, we'll know where to go, right? Because, and I say that because I don't have any of the footage. I don't know how, but I lost all the footage. I had
Ken
great footage.
Home.
We went to Havasu Lake and Parker and Mead Lake. I drained some of the desert landscape. It was awesome. I had some of the greatest video footage, drone footage of, I mean, it was, I was so happy with my collection of footage that I got over the weekend.
Yeah. I still have a temperature.
And I get home, and I plug the cord in, and I think what happened, I actually deleted the footage. Here's what happened. I put the cord in, I took it out of the drone, and I put it in this little thing that's got all my micro SD cards, and I put that in my pocket. So I come in the house, and I take it out, and I think it's this one, so I put it in, and I didn't see him on there, so no, but there were some old pictures on there, so I just I just formatted the card. I think they were on there because the videos were on no other card.
Right.
So.
But it all got deleted.
I think it all got deleted. I this is the best thing I can come up with. I don't know.
I think our heads are too high.
Oh.
I'm going to move this camera. Sorry. No, that one can stay. I just want to move this one.
Oh, there. That looks better.
You're crooked. I'm out of it.
I was making a joke.
All right.
I was making a
So
joke.
Ken lost all the footage that we took all day yesterday. Luckily, we traveled with a air mattress in our car. So I can just lay down on the air mattress while Ken does all his fancy footage and filming and fun
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, she was not really into it. So it was kind of like I was alone. That's fine. Oh, okay. Jesse, you... Man, she's still hacking. Mm-hmm. You're the hacker.
Yes, I am.
She's a hacker.
But we're going to play Family Feud.
Are we?
Yeah, because I love it.
There. Is that better? That's better. This thing keeps dropping. And the thing is
so we're up. Broadcasting live on TV Party App and Facebook Live.
Uh-huh. Hi, Jody. Yeah, I did.
Did you just post a Ken and Barbie video with no sound? I did just post a Ken and Barbie video. It was supposed to be our background. However, and that's why it's also backwards. However,
yeah, it's backwards.
It didn't publish in time, and we wanted to start the show, so we went with a white background.
Yeah.
And we'll fill it in later.
I guess everybody that gets our notifications is going to get that. Uh-huh. Oh, great. Great. We were trying to be neat and professional, and it didn't work out. And then we ran out of time.
And I'm sick. And so then we ran out of time. 20 and minutes behind and everything.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I still got my glasses on.
Normally,
I broadcast with my contacts on.
It's okay.
And I also put on fake lashes, and I also dye my hair. I put hair coloring on my hair, but I didn't have the energy to do any of that today.
Okay, well, we're going to try to have a little fun, too. So we're going to start off with...
Woo! The Ken and Barbie Show!
We're going to start off with Family Feud, okay? Because it just is fun to start off that way, and it gets everybody kind of involved, okay? So I'm going to read off the number one, okay?
Right. It's Facebook against TV Party App.
Round one. There's how many answers are on the board, okay? What are you going to...
I was gonna peek.
You can't peek.
All right, go.
Okay. One, two, three.
At least I got lipstick.
Four, five, six. Okay, top six answers on the board. Okay. Hola, you're getting it. You're already ahead of the game.
Hola.
I know. Hola.
You said hola.
Okay. Well, name one Spanish word everyone knows.
Hola.
That's number one answer. Oh, that's so funny. So, Sue, you're ahead of the game. You got the number one answer on the board.
Taco.
Okay. No.
C.
Yes.
Agua.
S-I-C. L-O-L.
Agua.
Hola, yes.
Agua.
That's agua. Hilarious. Anyway.
Agua. Agua?
No. So we have...
Pukwoti.
Hola. Pukwoti. What?
Pukwoti.
Paquito.
Paquito!
Oh my god. Paquito. What'd you say? I'm a winner. Yes, you are a winner. But there's six answers. Come on, Sue. Keep going. You got Ola. You got number one answer. Okay, but there's six answers. And C has already been said. Paquito is not an answer. Or not on the board.
C.
You already said that.
Was it on there?
Yes.
Oh, woohoo! I missed
what
it.
What kind of cough syrup are you drinking? Okay, so
no, that's Spanish for no,
it's not on the board.
Uno.
Yes, it Uno is on the board.
Woo!
Uno is on the board. Uno. Okay.
And dang, a shot for each right answer.
Dang, a shot for each right. A shot of cough syrup for her. That we should have played that. A drinking game. Yeah, well, we could have made the Family Feud into a drinking game.
A card game. I'm going to get my...
What? Your throat lozenger?
No, the spray.
Oh. Yeah, she's been going to town on Chloraseptic also.
This is my third bottle of Chloraseptic. It numbs the pain in my throat.
Okay, keep on going. We still have answers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 answers left on the board.
I think I gleeked. How many answers on the board?
We still have answers. Chloraseptic. Yes. Okay, we still have 4 answers on the board.
Okay. Alto. Stop.
No, it's not on there. It's not on there.
But, agua.
But you were close. There is something that means like... not necessarily stop, but, you know.
But go? Hola.
Opposite.
Bye. Hasta luego.
Is that?
No. Hasta la vista.
Keep going.
Me llamo Barbie.
I think hasta la vista. Is that like Italian or something? I don't know what you're saying. Okay.
Mi alma
agua,
Barbie.
Somebody, yeah, Jody, somebody said agua is not on the board.
Como se dice lightbulb en el español?
Uno is on the board. Uno.
I said Uno Deborah. Like an hour ago.
No, you did not.
Yes, I did.
No, you did not. Deborah got
watch this back.
No, you did not say Uno. So,
agua.
Hola, uno, si, and
alto.
Cinco. No. No, cinco is not on here.
Dos. Two.
That's just Arnold.
¿Cómo se dice light bulb in el español? Mi alma. Mi alma Barbie.
No.
¿Cómo se dice?
I'm waving.
Goodbye
I'm waving.
In español.
I'm waving. I'm waving.
Goodbye.
Everybody knows what I'm doing in Spanish.
You're saying goodbye.
That's English. Come on.
Hasta luego.
Is that Spanish?
Adios!
Thank you. Deborah. To the rescue.
Oh, Deborah, go.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Barbie did say Uno, see?
Barbie did say Uno. Well, okay. Well, you threw out, like, a bunch of answers, and you're not supposed to play that way.
Okay.
So, very good. Okay.
So long, farewell, adidas and goodbye.
And then, so there is another, there's two more, but I don't know what this one is.
It so I can't see it.
I don't think we're going to get that. O-L-E. Ole? Ole?
Creole.
Ole? Huh?
Creole, like crazy Creole mommy.
What are you talking about? It's O-L-E.
Ole, 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 ole.
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 Ole is an answer.
Ole.
Adios. Oh, yeah. No, never mind. Sorry. It was close to the next answer. The next one on the board. It's not. Okay. My bad. Okay. Here's a hint. I am.
Mi alma pin. Oh.
I am.
Him and her.
I am a.
Man.
And she is a.
Bar doing some of the music.
I am a. And she is a.
Human.
In Spanish, please.
You're a chica. I'm a chica. Hombre!
Oh, close. There's another word for it.
Señor!
Close.
Señora!
close.
Señorita!
Close.
Señorita? Margarita!
What? I'll be way
Margarita?
Off.
Is margarita on there?
That's a drink.
I know, it's a Mexican Senora. Drink.
No, that doesn't have anything to do with the clue that I gave. I gave you
going
a clue.
Going away to Margaritaville.
Olay is on there, but I gave that one away. Okay, I am a...
Boy. Man. Amigo!
Amigo! It's on there, amigo.
A friend. There are amigos.
Senorita. Amigo. Amigo and amiga.
Did you guys hear a whisper?
Look, amiga. Amigo.
See, they're with
and
me. Margarita
amiga.
is a Mexican drink.
I told you that. I said we're looking for a. I am a. Never mind. I think
amigos!
You've had too much cough syrup.
Mi amigos,
syrup.
Por favor.
You've had too much cough syrup. Okay.
Nina done. Or Nina? Or Nino?
I don't know. Dunno. How about
I think
that?
It should have been taco.
How about finista?
How about one more round?
I don't know.
This round.
Do we want to do another round?
Yes, to perfection.
Do we really want to do another
ready?
Round? Well, I am if you are, but is there anybody else?
Oh.
Ready? Oh, this
name,
thing is not going to stand, is it?
Name an occupation that most likely cheats on their taxes.
An accountant.
Number one answer. Five answers on the board. Ken got the number
five
one
answers
answer.
On the board. And I didn't know that. An accountant.
Yes.
Cheats on their taxes? Yeah, because
most
they know all the...
Most likely to cheat on their
most
taxes.
Most likely to cheat on their taxes.
Can I name a person?
No. Well, I don't know. Can you?
Yeah.
Well, what's the
he
question?
Just was
read
in
the
news
question
for
again.
Doing
read the question again. What,
name an occupation that's most likely to cheat on taxes.
An occupation.
Lawyer! Doing, 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 doing!
Oh, Sue. Great job, Sue.
Good job, Sue. All right.
Okay, a lawyer.
Three more.
So, what? An accountant? A lawyer,
uh-huh.
Jody got it too. A lawyer, an accountant,
mm-hmm.
and a movie actor, president.
No.
president.
No. But it's somebody that we see a lot of.
A movie actor.
No.
Because, you know, they make tons of money. They could try to... somebody that we see... salespeople. Salesman? Salespeople?
No.
A doctor.
Yes! Jody, doctor! Go, Jody!
Jody got your clue. Your clue was easy for Jody. Somebody we see a lot of. Doctor. Mm-hmm. A doctor cheats
okay,
on...
two more.
Most likely to cheat on their...
Yep. Name an occupation.
I know.
Like
about loud.
Most
president.
Likely to cheat on... Cheat on taxes. Two more left. So we got accountant, doctor, lawyer.
A sports athlete.
No.
No.
Kinda. Self-employed.
Self-employed? Well, that's not a sports athlete.
Yeah, so a sports athlete's self-employed.
True. So self-employed.
Woot woot.
So if you're self-employed, you're most likely.
A chef! Food server! Well, I'll give it to Deborah.
Okay, was that it?
That's it.
Oh, cool.
See? When I am the leaderboard leader, we are efficient and effective. Freaking winners here.
Well, that's because you're just sick.
I am sick.
You are sick.
All right.
You're
so
sick.
So I'm sick. We did go on a trip to Vegas, and since today we were supposed to be coming to you live from Vegas, I wanted to tell you some Vegas facts that you probably don't know.
You have some Vegas
but
facts?
That you should know.
Okay. 20 facts about Vegas.
Yes. So, 20 facts about Vegas. Here we go. Number uno is there are 300 weddings a day in Las Vegas.
300?
Including one of them was Ken and Barbie's. Woot, woot, woot.
Yeah, okay. That was just one day, one in 1 year.
Yeah, that was 2007.
God, 300 a day?
300 a day.
Wow.
I thought we were special.
Vegas peeps cheat on taxes. Gamblers. Gamblers. Professional gamblers.
Yes.
You know
there's
they
a
do.
Reason why Vegas is known for their wedding chapels and quickie marriages. With over 300 weddings every day, it's the top wedding destination in the United States and second in the world. Most number of weddings in a single city, falling short of Istanbul. Istanbul.
Whatever.
I think Istanbul's number one because they have the highest population.
Well, that could be.
And don't they have like 7 days of weddings? For one person.
I don't know. Move
couple.
On to number two. We don't need to do.
You can gamble at the movies.
You can gamble at the movies. Gambling is probably
we
popular
did have a beautiful
in the city
wedding.
Because casinos literally everywhere. McCarran Airport has an area of slot machines. Yeah, we know. I've gambled.
I won
at
$25 at McCarran Airport.
At the airport.
In the slot machine.
At the airport.
Woot woot.
Yeah, I've
go
lost.
Go Wheel of Fortune.
I lost $25.
Wheel.
In the airport.
Oh, fortune.
That's her favorite game in the casino.
Yes.
Kind of like me too.
And if I win a penny,
I do too because
I'm
you
like,
get to spin the wheel. You got to like spin the
yeah,
and then it gives you like this the smallest number on the board every time.
Yeah. Here's another little known fact about Vegas: if you have a seizure disorder, Las Vegas can put you into seizures quicker than anything else you've ever been to.
Okay. Here's number three, the $15,000 electricity bill lighting up the Luxor Pyramid's shining light is not cheap. The cost of electricity for keeping it lit for just an hour is $51. That would equal to about $15,300 a month. Imagine getting that bill in the mail. Oh, wow. Who knew?
I'm like, turn the lights off. Deborah is right. We did not play any games last time we were in Vegas.
We didn't. Yeah, no, that's, man.
That's, I was
and that's the way to
crazy
do it, man.
Brain
if you can go to Vegas without gambling.
It's a good time.
Yeah, it is.
Especially if you went the way we went and we
well,
had,
you
like,
don't come back unhappy.
Parties.
You don't come back as broke.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you never know which one, y'all. You got to do is play once to hit that jackpot. Why people eat more shrimp in the desert?
I eat zero shrimp.
There must be something in the water in Las Vegas that makes people crave shrimp. Consumption of the shellfish in Vegas is over 60,000 pounds per day. That's higher than the rest of the United States combined.
Wow.
What? In Vegas? Did you ever imagine?
Can you imagine? How is it even fresh in Vegas? There's no ocean to keep the stuff
fresh. Oh, they haul
fresh.
It in fresh every single day. I mean, holy crap. That's incredible. The 50-ton lion, the largest bronze sculpture in America, is housed in Las Vegas. The largest bronze sculpture.
We have a picture with it.
Yes, as many people do. It just so happens to be the MGM Grand Hotel's mascot, the Bronze Lion, weighing in at 50 tons.
50 tons.
50 tons. Oh, my God. Okay.
You know what 50 tons is? That's 25 elephants.
Yeah. Yeah.
Approximately.
Yeah, the freshness of shrimp in the desert. Shrimp in the desert is always fresh.
No. We're all ocean. We're all beach, no ocean. It's not fresh.
It's all beach, no ocean. So where's the shrimp?
Right?
Okay. But it does have a higher altitude. You know, and I don't know if it's on here, but in Arizona, they tried to transplant a saguaro cactus to Las Vegas. And it does not work. It dies every time.
You know what a saguaro is, right? It's what you think of when you see a cactus, and it's like...
It's the cactus.
The two arms. The cactus that you see in cartoons.
Yeah, the arms. The arm cactus.
Mm-hmm.
It dies. In Vegas, it dies.
Yep.
It does not survive. The Invisible Golden Nugget. In 1954, Las Vegas Golden Nugget Hotel did not actually have a golden nugget on display. The most common question, the most common questions from visitors at this time were, how much does it weigh? And where is it? Well, I don't think that, yeah, why would they put a golden nugget on display? I think there's enough criminals that they would just forget the bank and try to rob the nugget. At least I would. If I was a crook, if I was looking to rob something, I'd be like, give me that thing. I'll just melt it down. It's got no fingerprints. It's got no way. I'd just melt it down into a different shape, and it's mine. I don't know. Is that good that I think like a crook?
No.
But I wouldn't get caught. Well, I might get caught stealing it.
I'm back.
So, gray water abounds. It's not allowed,
yes,
but
really.
You probably wouldn't want to attempt to swim in water structures in Las Vegas. The fountains and man-made lakes used something called gray water, which is actually recycled water from sinks, bathtubs, and showers throughout the city. So the fountains that you see, like, that are
would
like,
you ever get in the water in the fountains now? I never, before I wouldn't have thought twice about it. When we went for like a cheerleading event or something.
You like showered under a...
Yes! I even did a modeling shoot at the Caesar's Palace in a side fountain, and now
But why would you shower under a concrete penis anyway?
They cut the penises off.
Well, actually,
it was probably our friend, Alex, swinging through, knocking the penises off.
It probably was Alex and Andrew. Adam.
From Amazing Race? Yeah.
Yeah, well...
Inside jokes,
sorry. Or the lady's nipples. Two showers.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on.
Might as well be cold water, and I posed in there.
Okay, here, number eight. It's an easy life. You can make a cushy living as a bartender in other parts of the country. People in the service industry, such as bartenders and cocktail waitresses, may not make enough money to make ends meet. But in Las Vegas, these jobs can pay out in six-figure salaries easily. It might be time to make the move to Nevada if you enjoy making or serving drinks. Wow.
I think you need a new job.
Wow.
You're no longer executive director of International Pain Foundation. Now you're going to serve
drinks. I'm a bartender.
Drinks.
I'm a bartender in Las Vegas. Who knew?
Holy. Not me.
And this says easily. Now, I was working in Scottsdale in Arizona. I was working in banquets out here. And what you can make in banquets in Las Vegas is twice the amount you can make here. You can make 80 grand out there in banquets. Note to self, for sure. Right?
Yeah.
Hello, if I'm down. And you could probably take a few yourself.
Probably.
I've bartended before. I know what it's like.
The only thing would suck is I wouldn't be able to, like, go, like if, for instance, here in Arizona, it's probably the same rule. You can't play bingo if your family member works at the bingo parlor.
Oh, so there's, you know, so they're just go to a different bar or do what?
I'd have to go, but I'd want to be with you, honey.
I'd serve you. You don't drink, though.
I know.
And cheat on my taxes, too. That's right. Vegas has it, man. That's right. The waitresses and bartenders, most likely to cheat on their taxes because it's cash tips. That's right.
That's good.
Good call, Sue. Visit Vegas for 288 years. There are around 105,120 hotel rooms in all of Las Vegas. 105,000 hotel rooms.
So to stay in every single hotel room,
that
it would
means
take
if
you
someone
288 years.
Just one night in every room in the city, it would take them 288 years. Wow, okay. Well, that was okay.
I wouldn't want to do that.
FedEx, blackjack, and luck. It's not surprising that people down in their luck turn tend to visit Vegas to try to get rich quick, but even Frederick W. Smith, whoever that is, the founder and CEO of FedEx. I guess I shouldn't insert those little things. Saved his company by gambling in Las Vegas. You know what? Charlie Ergen says that, you know, owner of Dish Network, I used to work there, that he says that he started off as a gambler. When FedEx had a hard time paying their $24,000 fuel bill, Smith took the company's last $5,000 to gamble and managed to win $27,000 on blackjack and kept the business afloat. See, that's the problem. We're not playing blackjack.
Yeah, we need to play blackjack.
Instead, Wheel of Fortune, what?
Wheel of Fortune!
Blackjack! Blackjack!
It doesn't sound...
Blackjack!
It doesn't
blackjack.
Sound as... doesn't sound as fun.
Blackjack! We're both sick. Oh, well. Okay. Vegas has loads of cash. It's a great place to live and raise a family. This is partially due to the state's lowest taxes in the country.
Isn't Florida good too?
Certain taxes present in other states that aren't in Nevada. The tourist industry in the city is so healthy that much of the money spent on tourism gets put back into funding for roads, schools, and parks.
Well,
how many parks did you fund?
I need to learn how to gamble too.
Yeah, well,
I piss off a whole blackjack table because I am playing by my own rules in my own head. And the people next to me are like, how dare you?
Yeah, but she plays Yahtzee on her cell phone. She has a Yahtzee game on her cell phone.
So I play with
Sue. So now, oh, you do? So now you know how to play blackjack, right? It's the same. Yahtzee and blackjack.
It's five cards and two cards.
Huh? It's
blackjack's two cards and Yahtzee's five cards. It's more like poker.
Jack, you get five cards on blackjack. Well, I mean, no, you just add up to whatever.
Same.
Whatever. Okay.
Barbie plays with
it's not all about gambling. You may not come to Vegas specifically to gamble, but you're very likely to end up doing so once you get there. A study conducted in 2013 showed that although 15% of the people primarily for gambling, about 71% do so during their visit anyway. So.
That's a lot.
71% do so anyway.
Oh, the people who say, I'm not going to gamble, still gamble.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, 71%. That's huge.
Yeah.
So, dig it. Number 13, dig it. If you're craving some blue-collar work while visiting, there's a heavy equipment playground. Feel free to drive around the various bulldozers
what?
And dump trucks.
Where do you do
the
that?
The park has available purely for fun. I want to do that. Where is that? We're going to have to look that up. I've always wanted to drive a bulldozer.
We need to go back to Vegas.
How fun would that be? I want to drive a bulldozer.
I want to see Ken drive a bulldozer.
Yeah, I want you to take a video of me driving a bulldozer. I want to drive a bulldozer.
New bucket list item.
It says, feel free to drive. I wonder if that means it's free. I don't know, but dig it. I got to dig it. I'm going to dig it.
We're definitely looking that up.
Going to sell my Honda Fit.
What's a Honda Fit?
I don't know. It's a Honda that's in shape. Your Honda looks like it's in really good shape. It's a Fit. It's in Fit. And buy a bulldozer? Oh, well, you might not get a very big bulldozer for the same price as a Honda. Just saying. Okay, so the blacklist. Many people have been banned from Las Vegas for one reason or another. The city even has a black book with a list of people who are not allowed to set foot in any of the casinos.
Which is so crazy because don't you want to be in somebody's little black book?
Not
if it bans you from Vegas. You'd think that'd be a red book, not a black book. Because, you know, you're in the red or you're in the black. In the positive or the negative. I don't know.
I think you just got caught trying to cheat.
I don't know.
And therefore, you are banned. In the black book, you go. Okay, number 15. $16.7 million in winnings. A 25-year-old software engineer visiting Las Vegas put $100 at a slot machine at the Excalibur and ended up winning $39 million. This was the largest sum ever won in the Las Vegas slots. And the odds were stacked at 1 in 16.7 million. He definitely got lucky that night. Holy crap, $39 million.
Wheel of Fortune.
So his slot winnings machine. Of the $39 million was his winnings were $16 million. 25 years old. Wouldn't that suck if you were underage and you were just like passing through and you did that? Sorry, you don't get that.
You better hope your parents are right next to you.
Oh, well, they got it on camera. Your parents sitting next to you means nothing. Sorry, your son pushed the button. We're not going to pay you. That's what they would say, too.
Yeah.
For sure. Thanks for the animation, Deborah. Okay. What is number 16? Lucky math. The slot machines are set at a certain payout rate. Legally, the machines have to have at least a 75% payout, meaning that if you put in $100, at the very least, you should get $75 back. Sometimes it's not all about luck. It's about math. I don't feel like that's very true.
I don't think that's true at all.
No. No, no.
I think they hit lucky streaks.
You get, yeah. But, well, it pays
I'll
you.
I'll even, like, take my money
lets
out.
It win enough
and put
to,
it back in. Just to start that over. So to trick the machine to think a new person's sitting.
We do that all the time. It's like, cash out. And then she'll hand it to me and I'll put it in and play for a little while. And then I'll cash out. And I'll hand it to her and she'll play for a little while. Yeah, I know. We're corny like that. But it makes your money go a little bit further. And you're trying to mentally...
Trying to trick the
mentally
machine.
Mentally, you think you're tricking the machine. Probably not done a damn thing, but losing your money. Anyway, so whatever works for you. If you do have something that works for you, please share. Vegas royalty. Private bowling is available at the Palms Casino Resort. If you really want to live like royalty while in Vegas, consider staying at the Palms in the...
What's private bowling?
Kingpin Suite that has two fully functional bowling lanes inside. It's a perfect fit for any dude. Oh, a dude.
Yeah,
huh?
A dude, not a girl. That's not a girl thing.
Yeah, I don't think bowling alley in my room would be really what
Can
I'm
you
looking
imagine?
For. I'd rather have a pool table in my room.
Is this number one, meaning someone wants to
do it?
Do it with us?
Requesting guests. No.
All right.
Hi, Melissa. Gambling in the Boulder. No gambling in Boulder. Residents of Boulder City, located just outside of Vegas, have to get their gambling fix in the city before returning home. This is because their hometown is one of the only cities in Nevada that prohibits gambling. I never knew that.
I didn't either.
Boulder? Because you go through Boulder, or after you get through the, if you're driving, you cross the Hoover Dam.
I know one thing they
and
don't.
And you go into Boulder, is that right?
Yeah.
And then Henderson and Boulder,
yep.
It's all like right there.
Yep,
you can't gamble in Boulder. Laughlin? That's way the hell down by Havasu.
I don't know. What do I know? Are you kidding me? If it's not in the GPS, I ain't getting there.
That's for sure. That is totally, totally, totally for sure. She couldn't even tell you if we crossed the river without GPS.
Well, it said it was a thing that starts with a P. A river versus a lake.
That starts with a P. What? Pacific Ocean? pond? Is that right?
It said that we were. It said this is a lake, and it's like not even a lake. It's a full-on river with the water running, and it says lake.
Yeah.
Anyway.
She got lost.
I did.
Well,
luckily
not
I
really
wasn't
because
driving.
She had GPS. Yeah, she'd be like circling the lake. Is that right? Because you can't circle a river. You can't circle a river.
And one thing I saw that was so funny yesterday, driving back from Vegas, there was a bridge called the London Bridge.
And it said, in Lake Havasu.
And it said, London Bridge, 1731 to 1957 or something like that. I'm like, but the bridge is still open and people are still using it.
Yeah, why did they give it a death date?
Why did they give it a death date? When the,
why is there an end date? Because it was from London.
It was the London Bridge from London that came to the United States.
They disassembled. Has anybody been to Lake Havasu? If you've been to Lake Havasu, you know that the London Bridge goes over a... It's like
not a London Bridge.
It's like a river.
Like Lundy,
it's a short river
like Lundy,
that
Lundy.
Separates the two. It's one lake, but there's a river that connects them. I don't know if I'm making sense. Okay, but it seems like two lakes, and this river connects them. It's one lake, but...
We got another animation.
I even flew my drone under the bridge. I lost that video, too.
Ken keeps sitting on my dress.
I'm so upset I lost all my video. Okay, almost done. Number 19, Megalopolis. Megalopolis. I did say it right. Hotels. The Las Vegas is home to 15 of the world's top 25 hotels. This includes the Venetian, Caesar's Palace, and the Bellagio, just to name a few.
I stayed at all three of those.
Yes, Fergie sings about the London Bridge. Yes, yes. I love it.
Yes. I love Fergie. Let me tell you this story.
Oh, God. Go ahead. I know what story it is.
So, one time, well, lots of times, but this one particular time, we were at the finale for American Idol. And we were standing on the red carpet. And I see this group coming down. We're like telling people to basically like where to go, what to do. And
well,
But
people that were coming up to us, we were like, we didn't know them. We're like, yeah, everybody that comes down, because we didn't get a very good spot at the red carpet. So we were standing there like, well, we get all the band members, not the singers, you know. We get all the people that are not celebrity famous. So we're standing there and we're talking, and Jim Taylor, comedian, I said,
he's a comedian. His daughter was the girl that cried with Sanjaya.
Nobody knows this. Go on.
Everybody knows this. Go on.
So anyways... We're making jokes like, well, even if it was somebody famous, we wouldn't know it and we'd show them the exit. And guess who we showed the exit to?
Fergie! That way! I thought she was with Janice Dickinson. And I thought she was one of Janice's models because Models Inc. was on.
Exit is that way.
And yeah, so we...
She looked at us like, oh my God.
Like, everybody wants my autograph, and you just want to tell me how to leave.
We didn't know
it was Fergie until she got up on stage to perform, and we were like, oh, crap. We were with Fergie and didn't even know it.
Yeah, we looked at each other like, oh my God. We told her where the exit was.
Yeah. So, at the after party, we apologized.
She's beautiful. I didn't realize Fergie was so beautiful.
I thought she was a model with... Janice Dickinson.
It's because we listened to you. That's why we thought...
Everybody listened to me. I was like, oh, she's a nobody. I even said, she's a nobody. I mean, Apple was with them, and Will.i.am was with them, and I full-on was like, oh, she's a nobody. Like,
whew. Well, there you go. Okay, last one. Number 20.
Apparently, she's
drum roll.
As gorgeous as a model person.
There's a room for all Burbank at the MGM Grand. All of Burbank at the MGM Grand. The MGM Grand Hotel and Casino has 5,043 rooms, making it the largest hotel in the country and the second largest in the world. That's almost enough rooms for everyone in the entire population of Burbank, California, to have their own room.
Let me tell you, one time stayed there, and there's like different parts of the hotel that you stay in.
No. They built another park called MGM Parks.
MGM Parks.
Well, that's
separate
from
the... Well, we didn't know that. And so we went and checked in on the MGM side, and so the MGM Parks side...
They said, oh, you're in the parks.
Oh, you're in the parks. And we're like, oh, okay, we'll just walk through the hotel to get there. 40 hours later.
Well, no.
It was a couple hours later.
Like 40 minutes later. I mean, walking, it's a long walk. especially in the tower that we were part in, it's like, oh my God, don't ever try to walk from the MGM Grand to the MGM Park.
I made Ken go back and get the car and bring it to the other side of the resort so that I didn't have to walk that much.
It was ridiculous.
It was horrible.
But the MGM Grand itself has 5,000 rooms.
Right.
That's not even counting the park, MGM Park.
Wow.
I do believe. Excalibur used to have, set a record for the most rooms, and it had, 3,000, you
Excalibur?
Know? Hey, the Excalibur, when it was new, it was awesome. It was badass. I love the Excalibur. It's still one of my favorites.
Well,
just
what?
Because of the shape and the medieval times, and it looks like a castle. I mean, how can you not like the Excalibur? The Luxor is really cool.
The Luxor is really
What's your favorite
awesome.
Hotel in Vegas? Anyone. Deborah, what's your favorite
the
hotel?
The Mirage.
Do not say the Rio.
The Bellagio.
Well, that you've stayed at.
The Bellagio?
I've never stayed at the Bellagio.
The Mirage?
I still like the... I've only been in one. Oh, really? The Rio? Okay. Well, I guess that could
the
be
the Cosmopolitan Hotel has the absolute...
Sue!
Best...
Sue is...
Sue has never been to Las Vegas.
Well...
The Cosmopolitan Hotel has the best... pizza place, and it's you cannot. This
the Cosmopolitan
is
really awesome.
Of Vegas,
yeah.
You cannot.
That was Deborah's first trip to Vegas, also.
Oh my gosh, you cannot.
Hi, Rhonda.
Let me finish.
Go ahead. Finish.
Hi, Rhonda. You cannot miss the Cosmopolitan hidden pizza joint.
It's yes, you can miss it because
well,
you
everybody
can't
misses
find
it, but I'm telling you about it. So now you know the insider secret. You gotta go. They have the most amazing pizza. You cannot ask an employee about it.
They don't know where it's at.
They will say, we don't have a pizza joint.
It's not advertised.
It's hidden on the third floor.
It's not seen.
Across from Holstein's, down this long hallway that's filled with
pictures.
I think
it used to be Holstein's right there, but yeah.
It's got a long hallway. You think, where am I going? This isn't right. And you just randomly are walking to find something, and all of a sudden it opens up and it's a whole pizza joint.
It's a wall. I mean,
it's
a,
so
I'm sorry,
good.
It's a hall. It's
You're
a
like
long
just...
hall, and it's got just photos mm-hmm. all over the walls, on both sides of the walls. So
yeah.
You're just walking down this long hall, like, where am I going? So you don't even think it's nothing advertised, so you think you're not even supposed to be there. But whenever you get to the end, you turn and look, and there's a whole pizza joint. It's pretty cool. Yeah, so we're doing good, Rhonda. We just asked everybody here at Rhonda, tell me, what is your favorite hotel in Vegas that you've stayed at? Deborah's only time in Vegas was when she stayed with us.
I'm sorry, Deborah. We need to go back and do
that
again.
But that was a great experience of Vegas, Deborah. I mean, if my first experience of Vegas was like the one that you got, Deborah, that would have been really cool. I mean, you got to be Voodoo Lounge on the top. You got to be on the top of the Omnia. The Omnia was on Caesar's. It was a rooftop on Caesar's Palace.
Mm-hmm.
And then what else did we do? You didn't do the zip line, did you, Deborah?
No, but we watched other people do it.
Yes, Michelle Costa did.
You want to hear something funny? So there was a film
Rhonda,
crew
have you
when
been
we
to
were
Vegas?
There. When we were there with Deborah. Happy congratulations for
Never
Maverick.
Been there. Oh my God.
Joshua and Megan had Maverick.
Oh, well congrats. Hey everyone. Congrats to Josh and Megan for their newborn son.
Maverick.
Awesome. Send us pics, man. Well, I guess we can just
Actually,
go to your Facebook
pics.
And saw pics. Yeah.
I saw pics, and he looks exactly like you. He looks like a baby Josh.
Josh, you look like a baby. Or does Josh's baby look like Josh?
Josh's baby looks like him.
I kind of like it the other way around. Josh, you look like a baby.
Oh.
Oh, well.
Okay, so I forgot what story I was telling.
Well, let me tell you one. We saw, beautiful baby. I'm sure it is. Yes, well, we saw pictures on Facebook. 2 days old. Wow, it's a birthday every day. It's a birthday every day until you reach one, right?
It is. It's a birthday every day until you reach one.
And I'm sure you give him presents every single, well, he gives you a present every day.
Yeah, probably at least six a day.
Or something.
Okay. And, okay, so I forgot what I was doing a story
We're
and I forgot.
We're doing the zip line.
Oh, no. The story was, so there was a film crew, and they were sitting, right next. I had, planted myself down on a seat, And I'm watching everybody. I don't drink. I don't do drugs. So I'm just drinking water. And
yeah, she fits right in Vegas.
I fit right in, right? On a rooftop, wind blowing through my hair.
Go on.
Reality celebrities all over the place. And this film crew's filming next to me, like people's stuff. So they took a break and they sat down and I just was being my own self. And I was like, oh yeah, I can. They're like, do you have any talents or anything? Because you do reality TV. And I was like, yeah, I can rap. And they were like, yeah, let's hear you rap. So I was rapping, and then the audio guy was like, well, I sing. And he started singing, and it was this whole thing. And then the next day, I started having reactions to the lights and epileptic type
oh, God, she was symptoms. Puking.
I was puking and...
and what? Yeah, she was just puking. The next morning, she...
and I have these special thick glasses, and I had them on. I went down to the
next... because our prescription.
I went down to the... Yeah. I went down to the...
Sorry.
I went down to the reality check-in, because we were at a reality event, and I went down there, and the cameraman came over, and he's like, oh, you shouldn't drink so much. And I was like, what are you talking about? I don't even drink. And he's like, oh, don't you have a hangover? I was like, no, I have a seizure disorder.
Everybody thought she had a hangover.
Everybody thought I had a hangover because I had sunglasses on. But he's like, I mean, you were just so entertaining last night. I just figured you were drunk off your ass. And I was like, no, literally, I was drinking water. I don't drink alcohol. And I wasn't.
Woo!
So, anyways, so then I actually won an award for social media. And I went up, and when I went up to accept the award, I said, I just want to do some awareness really quick and let everybody know that I don't drink, but I have microlepsy, and this is what happens, and these lights kick off my seizures and messes up my brain. And then after that, then people were like, oh, thank you for sharing. And then they started sharing their stories and found out that there's a lot of people in reality TV that have chronic pain or migraines.
How about
or
people in
endometriosis.
General? Yeah.
But you don't think people in reality because you get screened, and well, so you're supposed to like
hey, here's
be
a new,
healthy.
Here's a new there's a new reality show. Josh, are you still with us? There is it's a singing show. It's the stupidest, dumbest show I've ever seen. It's The Mask. The Mask Singer. Barbie is starting to watch it. I'm like, turn that shit. It's
every single time someone performs, I say, why am I watching this?
I know.
Why am I watching this?
Awful. It's awful.
It's awful.
Yeah, you need another cup, right?
I do.
Yeah, it's bad. I mean, it's just, you can't even really follow along because this person like sings, but you don't have a list of people to guess who it is, so you're just guessing like out of the wind, like a football player, and then you gotta name the football player like as if you've ever heard this football player sing. It's just okay, Josh. So yes, do you like the show? Have you seen it?
Has anybody else seen the show besides us?
Please tell me you think it's as stupid as I think it is. It's dumb. It's gotta be just dumb.
Like I
dumb.
Said, I watch it the whole time, dumb. And I say, Ricola. Why am I watching this? Ricola.
You like to start coughing?
Okay.
No.
So,
Halls.
Halls.
A free advertisement for Halls.
I have three different types of Halls in there.
And chloroseptic. See, when I get sick, I just start dosing on Alka-Seltzer gel tabs, and I'm fine.
I can't have Alka-Seltzer gel tabs.
Josh, if you haven't seen it, don't waste your time
on
it.
Don't waste your time.
It's horrible, dumb, and it's
a baby screaming and crying would be better to listen to.
But now I'll watch it. Okay, but don't say I didn't warn you. You're going to waste your time.
Can you have our weather? No.
Can
you
we
must
have your
come
weather?
Here
Rhonda,
and visit
did
to
you get
experience
snow?
The weather
you
here.
Got snow, didn't you? Rhonda got snow.
Or be like Jody and move here.
Welcome
back,
Denver.
Jody. Woo-hoo!
Yeah.
Okay. So, Ken and I did a reality show. Well, multiple. But one called Extreme Time Cheaters.
Oh, this is
and,
great.
And yeah. One of the guys that was on our first episode, his name was Robert. And he... So, Ken finds this new reality show to watch called In for 60. In for 60.
No. 60 days in. You can find this on... I was doing a beta test. Anyway, long story. I was looking for some on-demand shows, and this is on A&E. A&E, I came across this thing that says 60 days in. And it's about a group of people that agree to go in prison, in jail.
They go to jail for 60 days. They did nothing wrong.
They go in to see what it's like to live there, but also to provide intel to the and most of the officers don't know that they are a part of a team, okay? But they go in for 60 days. Well, we're watching it and we're like, hey, that's Robert, the guy that was on Extreme Time
Cheaters. The guy on Extreme Time Cheaters that eats everything in shake form.
In a blender?
In a blender. He's like, oh, I'm really going to miss my blender. This is so funny.
We thought it was funny because we knew in his episode or his segment of Extreme Time Cheaters, he blended everything. And it was his way of saving time. So he just blended everything.
So instead of eating a hamburger, he drinks his hamburger.
Right. And so he can take it on the go. And it was
Now he was in jail for 60 days. But he got $3,000 an episode.
Per episode. So I don't know how many episodes he's in, but we just started watching it.
He's probably in 12 episodes.
We've watched like 3 episodes now. Mm-hmm. And it's fascinating. I'm going to like binge this thing.
We're watching all the seasons, all the shows.
If you have A&E or On Demand, it's on A&E.
I mean, they got to like not get in a fight. And then one guy called the other guy a bitch. Hey, bitch. And... like, not to be mean, but in prison, that is, like, fighting words. That's fighting words.
Oh, dang, Sue. Where's Sue at? Hi, Dana. Wow, you're getting... So everybody is stocking up. They're taking all the water and bread out of the aisles. Did you see?
Yeah, well, Rhonda said they're getting 6
inches. I know, 6 inches. My mom just sent me pictures. They just got 6 inches of snow.
And Virginia is pouring snow too. My sister sent me a video of her boys out playing in it.
Yeah, well, we are nice and toasty and warm. I'm in shorts.
I'm in a tank top. Well, I'm in a pretty little dress.
Yes. I'm in my Good Luck Vegas shirt.
And my shirt was blingy.
Did not bring any luck for me.
Kind of matches his.
Yeah, well. But so anyways,
Robert,
this guy is in jail, and he's doing he's saying everything wrong.
She's in North Carolina.
Oh.
Yeah, so Robert.
Deborah is in North Carolina.
Deborah's in North Carolina.
Deborah is on TV Party Out. We haven't announced that, really.
We're on TV Party Out.
We're broadcasting
right
on two cameras, one on Facebook and one on TV Party App. If you have
if you're like, where are these comments coming from? It's probably the other one.
Yes. It's chilly in the 40s. Are you going to get snow, Deborah?
No, Sue said they're going to get rain. But it's snowing in Virginia.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. Boo.
We're
going to
be in Virginia the last week of February.
I don't mind rain. I like rain. I mean, not every day. But I guess because
rain is painful.
Because we're in the desert, I invite it when it does come.
What's it like in Washington State? Washington, Washington, Washington State.
You can tell she's from a marching band.
But from Washington State.
Close your marching band down. Won't you march off the field? March out of here.
I bet you Josh is right now going like this. On, but to the end. Honor and glory.
He probably is. He's a sports fan.
Ow!
That did it.
Did you hear that?
No, cheer about that one. Oh, did you pull
hair? Oh my God, I pulled my hair out.
I thought, I didn't hear you hit the chair with your hand. I was like, what happened? Oh, that's too bad. Well. Hey, Dana, how's George? Hope everything's well. Happy New Year. Happy New Year to everybody.
Oh my God.
Everybody, Happy New Year. Is it too late to say Happy New Year?
Oh.
Are you still pulling your hair?
Oh, I pulled a chunk out.
Oh. I'll take it.
Do you ever come to Maryland?
I'll take it. If you want to give me some of your hair.
Yes, we actually, on February 28th, we're going to be at the NIH in Maryland.
Do you know what the NIH is?
National Institute of Health.
It's the National Institute of Health. I'm glad you gave him a chance to answer that.
You have so much hair, you can spare it. Man, that's.
I know. I'm ready to take it. I want your hair.
You need to find your wig.
You see my hair?
That would be so funny. That reminds me of Impractical Jokers.
Right. See my hair? Yes.
George is good. You probably got hired full time for APS. Oh, APS. Go awesome.
Hey, nice. Very cool. Very cool. Very cool. That's good.
Ken Hot. Yes. Do you watch The Bachelor? So, yes. I watched The Bachelor. What does Ken call it? Garbage or something like that?
No. I don't. The Bachelor?
Yeah.
No. I think it's a bit slutty. I mean, you know, it's like, would you, if you were on there, would you want to date him if he's kissing
no.
or kissed every one of these girls?
No. Nope.
Including you?
Depends on how much they pay me.
So, I mean, it's just kind of weird like that. Depends on how much they pay me.
You guys know.
I'm just saying.
The reality TV is not real. If it had to be real, there'd be no reality.
Fuck no. See, that's what I'm saying. It's like,
do I watch it? Yes.
She watches The Bachelor, yes.
I watch almost all reality shows.
And then whenever she goes, oh my God, I'll turn and say, what was it?
And I like reality because it's fake, and I like to see how it's edited and produced and, you know, that type of thing.
Yes. Dana, you weren't here whenever I talked about my drone story. I took some of the most amazing footage over the weekend, and I accidentally deleted it all. I'm still kicking my own ass. It's just,
Hours of video. He deleted all of it by accident.
Probably, there was probably...
I don't want sloppy seconds or thirds. Yeah.
Oh.
I would be like, get your toothbrush and brush your teeth if you want to kiss me.
Yeah, there was probably over an hour of good 4K quality video.
Yeah.
Bummer.
Yeah.
But we videoed, we droned.
I love Big Brother. Celebrity Big Brother's coming up very shortly.
Big Brother. I just applied for... 21st. Hey, Deborah, did you apply for Twitter, Big Brother Twitter?
Twitter starts very soon, too.
I haven't heard anything.
They haven't announced who's on the show.
They haven't announced. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. I applied for Big Brother Twitter.
I was on Big Brother Twitter 1, season 1.
Yeah, we know.
But I am the...
Hey, are they still taking applications?
They are not taking applications.
Sorry, Deborah, you're
out.
But you can cheer for me now.
Okay. But here's the thing. Oh, man. My necklace is stuck. Here's the thing. I am the resident Will... I will be the host of all of the future Big Brother Twitter roundtables for the jury.
I saw a Bachelor Watching. What's it say? I saw a Bachelor Watching shirt at a
Target
the other day. A Bachelor Watching shirt.
Not too much going on.
I miss it. I don't know.
Can you undo this?
Now, brown cow. How did you do that? Okay, I gotta twist this. Coming around.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming
Stop.
Round the mountain.
Stop! Nobody
when
wants
she
to hear
comes.
That.
She'll be coming
Stop.
Round the mountain.
Stop! Oh my God.
That's what little girls are made of.
Sugar,
I think,
and I
spice
twisted.
And everything nice.
I think I went the wrong direction. So now I gotta.
Big Brother is awesome.
Well,
got lots of Big Brother friends.
And I'm just pulling on it. I should probably just cut it, huh?
Aww.
Well.
Aww.
Hey. Oh my goodness. How did you do this?
Have a good evening.
Okay. Yeah, now we're just, nobody wants to.
Yeah, just leave it until the show's off the air
and
we'll fix it. Get your tweezers or pliers or something.
Okay, I'm going the right direction now. I just gotta go.
Sorry, people. This is what happens when you're live. You never know what's going to happen.
Wow, you should...
I watch The Bachelor on Mondays.
You might not want to wear that with each other again.
Yeah, I think I want to just take it off now.
You should. I know it's pretty and ill, but... jeez.
All right.
Wow. Okay, well, I'm getting hungry. What's for dinner, everyone?
Well, for dinner...
I have chicken breasts.
That's what I was going to say.
It's like sautéing. It's all seasoned and barbecued. It's in the fridge. and I just got to put it in the air fryer. Who has an air fryer?
I do.
I love it. I love my air fryer. It's awesome. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I've lost 18 pounds, but then the doctor put me on medication. It was a shirt that said,
I watched The Bachelor on Mondays.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. The doctor put me on medication. I'm going to make a shirt and say, I watched the Ken and Barbie show on Sunday. Saturday. When... Never mind. You just got one? Do you like it, Dana?
You are the philosophy of successful actors 101.
Oh, boy. The philosophy of successful actors 101.
Probably. So, oh, she had steak and baby green beans. I'm having chicken and salad.
You can have green beans if you want.
And green beans.
Not in the air fryer. No green beans. Haven't used it yet. So it's new, huh? You just got it.
We gave my brother a.
You know, some people like the Instapot. A lot of people got the Instapot, which is really cool. I mean, because you can really like. We'll do like pulled pork, like in the slow cooker, and you can make that in like 15 minutes versus 5 hours in a slow cooker.
Yep.
However, we don't have that. We have the air fryer. Yeah, we've done steaks in the air fryer. We've done chicken breasts in the air fryer. Now, Dana, I know a lot of this. If you're still doing the keto thing, I don't know if you can do a lot of the things that I do from the frozen food section.
The keto diet did not... It worked and for I me found for these... a short time, like a couple of weeks.
Oh, and these, I got
And
you.
Then all the weight came back on. And once I could lose it, then I had the steroid injection.
Hey, I found these.
Gained even more.
I found these in the grocery store today.
These are for Ken, not for me.
Yes, I will be...
You're making
us
hungry.
Ghost pepper. Do you see it? Ghost pepper. I can't wait to put these in the air fryer.
It's backwards.
I'm going to put the... Well, that's why I said it says ghost pepper. I'm going to put... They're chimichangas. I'm going to put these in the air fryer. Air fryer. These are awesome. I can't wait. I might stick this in the
breath. And so I started doing the noon diet.
We've been on for an hour and six.
Yep. And I've been doing it. And lost some 18 pounds, then gained 3, then lost 2. So
You have the Instapot, and you use that a lot. Yeah, a lot of people like the Instapot.
But I want to lose 15 more pounds. That's my goal.
I'm hungry.
And so to lose weight, I'm gonna go eat some protein.
She's gonna eat cough drops. Don't
cough
don't let
drops.
Her, she's gonna drink chloraseptic and eat cough drops.
Mm-hmm. And also have some chicken.
And for snacks.
You're doing Noom? I'm doing Noom.
You're doing Noom also?
And...
That's what Barbie's doing, the Noom.
I'm on the second set of Noom, so I'm on month 5 of Noom.
Well, I'm just...
And I feel like I'm halfway done. As soon as I'm not sick anymore, and I stopped taking the medicine that made me gain weight, We'll drop the other 15 pounds, and then woot, 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 woot. Then I'm happy. That's me happy.
And that is woot, that woot, when you stop Noom?
Woot, woot. No, I'll probably continue with Noom-style eating, which is red, yellow, green.
Well, because you don't get... You're not, like, deprived
not
of the things that you like.
Right.
I mean, you still... But,
I mean, although I would like some cake.
But you can have cake?
I can have a little bit of cake, but then I have to give up something else.
But that's what I'm saying. If you want something, you can still have it.
Right.
Now, you have to, you know, obviously you pay attention to the calories intake. And But that's with anybody that wants to lose weight or exercise more. But, you know, if it's snowing outside, who wants
to
do
that? Or if
you
can't exercise.
This is true.
So.
This is true. So.
But the Noom people, the nutritionists and stuff that I worked with at Noom, they took all my health conditions into consideration, what I could physically do and not physically do, and all this stuff, and came up with something special that works for me. So.
Yum.
And it's actually working.
Very good.
Woot woot.
Okay. When are we going to be on next?
Oh, next we're going to be on January 19th, 2019.
What, you had to say 2019?
Yeah, because on my paper I wrote it wrong.
Oh, thanks, Jody. Is it my shirt you like? Yes. Are you all moved in, Jody? I know it's always hell moving, especially from state.
Moving sucks.
Moving is just a long. Things are boxed up again and again. And every time you move something, it gets damaged, and this moving is just a pain.
Red
well, and
Deborah
just moved to North Carolina. She went to, from states.
Purple. And Ken just moved his dad here.
I just moved my dad here. And on the way, we were pulling a U-Haul. And one time for him, the U-Haul started swaying.
I'm going to lose it!
Honestly, I thought we were going to wreck because the front of the truck was starting to do this also. I'm like, oh my God, we're going to die. And the only thing I think of is all of his shit in the trailer just going, whoop-boom, whoop-boom, whoop-boom. And then it happened to me. And the trailer starts doing this and the front of the truck is doing this. I'm thinking all of his stuff in there, whoop-boom. We get home and unpack his stuff and it didn't turn out too bad, but everything got nicked up.
I purged, Sue says moving's her opportunity
yes,
to purge stuff.
It is true.
I purge stuff all the time.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I am a purger.
And if you see something you
like, I am
like
opposite
to have,
of a hoarder.
Just offer a price. She'll sell it.
I will. What do you want? If it's a reasonable price, I'll sell it to you.
She will. Yep. But honey, that was my exercise bike. Oh well.
We didn't
somebody
need
offered
anymore.
Us money.
Yeah. Just come on over. It's a year-round yard sale.
Her mother had this ring, a princess ring. And she refused to give it to Barbie.
I was born in Thailand. It was my princess ring.
Because she knew Barbie would just sell it.
But I wouldn't. It's my princess ring from Thailand. Why would I sell that?
Because your mom knows you sell everything.
Well, if someone gave me the right price, but it has like legit like diamonds and rubies
so
and stuff on it.
So you lost it instead.
No, I found it.
You haven't found it?
There, I'm going to go get it.
Okay. Oh, this is going to be good. You do know where it's at? Uh-huh. Well, you lost it for a little while, I know. She couldn't find it for a while. She was so upset. I'm like, well, where is it? You probably sold it. You don't remember selling it? I just knew she had sold it. I guess she didn't. And then I thought she lost it once. Because she couldn't find it. You were upset because you couldn't find it.
Yep.
Did you find it?
Yep.
You got it on?
Yep.
Okay. Let's show the world.
This is my princess ring from Thailand because I was born in Thailand. And I'm a Thai princess.
Okay. There it is.
So, here it is.
I think it would just really hurt. Both cameras. There, use my head as a background.
Yep. It has all kinds of
use the white background.
Like legit stones in it.
It does. Oh, so. Lord. Oh, Lord. Okay, up close. There we go. See there? It's all fuzzy. Maybe your camera lens needs clean. That's why I look bald. Your camera lens needs cleaned. Okay, but honestly, man, if you had that on and somebody like punched you, that would leave
I'm a princess! And you get them back.
It's got all the colors, the gemstones there.
My mom kept everything. She was a hoarder, like a legit hoarder. And so I'm like
absolutely
here it is,
right there.
Opposite.
See it?
Yeah.
What? It's safe.
I was going to wear it during the show.
Oh, there you go. Don't hit me with it.
Hit me with your best shot.
Yes. Yeah, it's beautiful, right?
It's beautiful.
Okay.
So,
you
that's
know what's
my
beautiful
tiring,
is
but...
my dinner.
Okay. It's time for dinner, people.
It's time
Ken's
to
ready
eat.
To cook, so I'm ready to eat.
That's how it works.
Because I don't cook.
That's how it works in this house. I cook and she eats. Not always. I mean, she's got to pay attention. We got to pay attention to what she eats now. Noom. Because we noomed it.
Yep. All right.
Talk later. Nice to see you too, Deborah. And everybody
else.
Love
you all. Thanks for watching. We'll be back next week.
January 19th at 7 p.m. Eastern Central Time. Standard.
Eastern Standard Time.
Win-win. Yes. Enjoy your dinner, guys. Thanks. Thanks, Dana. Tell George we say hi. And we'll talk to everybody next week.
I was going to put the song on, but it shut down.
Oh, that's so sad.
So, because bye-bye. Hope is true. Because hope is you.
All right.
Bye.
Now.
Bye.
Have
talk
a great night,
later.
Everybody.
Hope is true.
Hold on. Let's see the animation. It's a cute cat.
Hi, Kim.
Okay. Oh, it's Kim and Phoenix.